Hello, this is the RPG Chick, back with another episode of Let's Play Syberia Blind. My voice is messed up, I have a sore throat. So, I don't know how many episodes of these I can play today, but we'll give it a try. I was not here when we left off last episode. I realized I've been looking around the game. I actually haven't played this for like 2 months, believe it or not. I'm not sure how that happened. Well, the Wasteland 2... the Wasteland 2 beta came out, so I decided to start putting that out, and it's been... Then I started uploading the Syberia after that, so... There's little cogs here that... Yeah, I missed. And interesting, they have little spots to fill them in where he had them. So he's drawing, so he's using these cogs to draw around, make a little diagram for himself. Maybe he's planning on making an automaton or something? Just guessing. Have no idea, guys. Anyway, back to the factory. So we missed a door there. So, yeah, I actually got stuck after this point. Played for quite a bit offline, you know, not recording. So as not to bore you guys to death. Trying to figure out where to go next, what to do. If I was missing something, and that's when I saw the cogs, and then I'm like, well, I still couldn't figure out where they went. Yeah, I think I went too far. Yeah. Mm. And I have a hot drink. That I will slurp from time to time, and I'll try to keep the coughing and sniffing to a minimum. Often my voice will get worse after the sore throat is gone, so I better get some sessions in now. So if after this you don't see a session, like an episode for a while, that's why. I'm sick. What can I do? Now, I don't think I've ever been over here. Can I do anything with these? Can't do anything here. There's a lot of, just scenery. Panels, I noticed. Not panels, screens, areas.
Yes, hello?
Kate, what happened to you, my poor munchkin? I've been trying to contact you for hours.
I'm in Europe, Ma. Job thing.
What? Europe? My God. Oh, I've got such happy memories of Europe. Some of them even involve your father, but that's enough of that. Tell me,
yeah.
Where are you? Paris? London? Venice?
Valle d'Hélène. Yeah, I know. It's a bit out in the boonies.
What in the world are you doing out there?
You know, business. I've got to see through the takeover of some old family business that's got a few debts. It's a really charming place, but there's one or two weird things going on here. I can't go into it now.
Oh, well, that's right. Your old mother's too dumb to understand it. You really do take after your father sometimes.
Mother.
Jeez.
Kate, you'll never guess who I saw yesterday.
Ma, I haven't got a lot of time, you know.
Frank!
Ma, please.
Frank.
I've got to go.
Frank! Frank Malkovich, the Russian opera singer. Well, maybe you don't remember him. He was quite a star in his day.
Listen, Ma, I really don't have the time. I'll call you back.
He is as charming as he always was. We spent the...
Mom, I really have to go. I'll call you back, I promise. Lots of love.
Kate!
Oh my God. Jeez, that would not get off the phone. So, am I looking at this or just going to that area? There's a door, too. What can I do here? What? It's going! Whoa. Oh, what's it doing with that? I guess don't get in that thing's way if you, getting in its way. Let's see what the hell it did. It went... Wait a second. Come on, Kate, hurry up. Can we go this way? No? Where's the... There it is. So put this thing here. What that is accomplishing, I have no idea. Okay. What about this? Oh, it's just... Okay. Is that it? What this? Huh? Alright, he appears to be moving around. Can't interact in any way, though. What's this? Oh, no kidding. We gotta free that guy. Okay, friend or foe? It's alive! Alive!
Oh, many thanks indeed! I am most embarrassed for you to see me like this. I lack a certain completion.
Yeah, no kidding.
You see, nobody here found the time to polish off the finishing touches. Honestly, these days, we really have lost the art of good workmanship.
Yeah. Maybe.
With whom do I have the honor of speaking? Could you please state your identity, articulating clearly?
My name is Kate. Kate Walker.
Allow me to introduce myself. I am model XZ2000. My common name is Oscar. I represent the technological zenith of this factory's production. I have been designed to drive a locomotive. A touch messy, but an essential task.
Hmm. Wow. Okay. Oscar. Does this just say the name again?
Have you logged my first and last name?
Perfectly. Kate Walker. Pleased to meet you.
Me too, model XZ2000.
Call me Oscar.
Please, all my friends call me Oscar. This fad for cryptic names is such a bore. Could you imagine being called by your passport number?
I suppose not, Mr. Oscar. Sir.
Just Oscar. You gotta call Mr. Oscar? Mission?
Do you know where I could find the factory paperwork?
I cannot reply to this question with precision. Try Anna Vorarlberg's office above the machine floor.
I was in there. What is it again?
Do you know where I could find the factory paperwork?
Yeah.
I can't...
Help?
When you are complete and totally functional, can you help me gather information about Hans Vorarlberg?
I'm afraid I can't, Kate Walker. Duty calls. Once I've recovered my feet, I have to see to my post on the train. It's waiting for its engineer.
Hmm. What can you tell me about Hans?
Does the name Hans Vorarlberg mean something to you?
Of course. He created me. But I'm sorry to say that I am yet to meet my maker.
Have you any idea where he might be right now?
No, Kate Walker, but I am sure I would experience great metaphysical satisfaction in his presence.
Great metaphysical satisfaction, I love it. What about the train?
You said you were a train engineer? What train would that be?
But Kate Walker, you have not seen the magnificent train waiting at the station?
I have, actually.
And where is that train going, Mr. Oscar?
The train is going far away. Very, very far away indeed.
Are you taking any passengers?
My duty is to drive the train. Above all, to avoid delays. An engineer prides himself on punctuality. I will agree with you, though, Kate Walker, that a train without passengers is hardly a train at all.
You haven't answered my question.
For further details, please consult Anna Vorarlberg.
I can't. She's dead. Can you tell me about Momo?
Do you know Momo?
No, Kate Walker.
What about automatons?
You are a very strange robot.
Automaton, if you please.
I'm sorry. I didn't mean to offend you.
Don't say robot.
Automatons have an additional soul auxiliary, you understand?
What?
I think so.
A soul? You have a soul? You guys have souls in you? And Anna?
Has it been a long time since you last saw Anna Vorarlberg?
72 hours, 32 minutes, and 20 seconds, to be precise. This regrettable absence explains the delay in my production process.
Anna Vorarlberg is dead, Mr. Oscar.
What do you mean by the notion of death, Kate Walker?
Broken. Deactivated. Worn out. Damaged. Unplugged.
Oh, that really is most bothersome. I'd rather count it on finishing my production.
And about the production?
Can I be of use to you?
Why, you certainly can. I absolutely must have my feet. My hands are model XZ2003. My feet are model XZ2005_B. Be careful. The model XZ2005_A has evidenced some rather embarrassing performance failures.
Like bugs?
Automatons do not have bugs, Kate Walker. They simply display functional idiosyncrasies.
I'm sorry, I didn't know. What do I have to do to get you a pair of feet?
Use the assembly line to construct them. You will need a production punch card, on which is recorded my body design data. Here is my own punch card.
Okay, I'll give it a go.
Thank you, Kate Walker.
Fit just about anything in that coat, huh? Now, if I talk about Anna again, because I've already told him that she's dead, this should change, right?
Has it been a long time since you last saw Anna Vorarlberg?
72.
Anna Vor.
What do you.
Broken.
Oh!
Hold on. I think it was the train?
You said you were a train engine.
But Kate Walker!
And.
The train is going.
Are you taking.
My duty is to drive the train!
You haven't answered my question.
For further details, please consult Anna Vorarlberg.
That's what I was thinking might change. She's unplugged.
Oscar, I am delighted to have met you. See you again soon, I hope.
Yes, Kate Walker.
All right. Let's see if we got anything over here that we can pick up. I mean, I don't... He told us to go back there, but I don't know if his feet are back there. That just... Okay, never mind. Never mind. Just jogging off to the door. And then open it very slowly. Alright. So I think doing this was part of the puzzle. We have to get upstairs to that. Up here. Run. Run. She won't run. Maybe I was supposed to go in after her, though. Okay. do. Right. Do I just put it in there? Punch card?
If that's going to work, it looks like something's missing.
Yeah, no kidding. Okay. Now what? His feet. Now, are those the A or the B? Because the A has a problem with them. I don't know what these represent. Can't take the card out. Alright, well I still need his hands, but let's go get the feet. Maybe he can provide me additional instructions or something. My voice is really horrible, I'm sorry guys. But I'm trying to keep on my deadlines here. I'm literally recording this today and uploading today. I will be, barring any catastrophe. Run, Kate Walker. Can't do consult with this. I don't know if these are the right ones. I don't know. But I suppose he'll know. Oh wait, no, I don't want to go. Oh, I thought I was going to go up there. I don't want to go up there.
Here are your feet, Oscar. I hope I haven't made a mistake.
These feet are incorrect, Kate Walker.
Mm-hmm. Well, how do I get the right ones?
Hi, it's me again. Can I trouble you a second?
In the situation I am in, nothing would give me greater pleasure.
Stand by, guys.
As bizarre as it may seem, I have the impression you are the only person who can help me.
I very much doubt it, Kate Walker.
Why do you say that?
What good am I without appendices, I ask you?
Oscar, I'm experiencing some problems with the general console.
Yeah.
It looks like I need more than your card to operate it.
To my knowledge, the console is in perfect working order.
Okay, I guess I must have forgotten something.
Most certainly, yes. I am counting on you, Kate Walker.
I have the wrong kind of wood.
Oscar, I am delighted to have met you. See you again soon, I hope.
Yes, Kate Walker.
I don't know what kind of wood I used. I don't even know what kind of wood I used to make these. Maybe I can tell by looking at it. Oh, he took the feet. They were darkish, weren't they? What's in here again? Alright, this is her office. Excuse me. Now, this music cylinder thing I took. Mm-hmm. Okay. And I looked at all this stuff. And I looked at this. Nothing around here. I don't know why she had the option to ask about that then, if she's already gotten everything she could get out of here. So I was wondering if I forgot something. Now, here's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna mess around with the wood settings and I'm gonna run it back and forth to him, see if I give him the right foot. And I'm gonna cut that down or speed it up or something. Let's try the lightest one. See, that's what kills me. How do I know which one is the right part?
Here are your feet, Oscar. I hope I haven't made a mistake.
These feet are incorrect, Kate Walker.
Here are your feet, Oscar. I hope I haven't made a mistake.
These feet are incorrect, Kate Walker.
Here are your feet, Oscar. I hope I haven't made a mistake.
These feet are incorrect, Kate Walker.
But this seems different. Wow. Like a giant bird face. I saw that before. Just because I chose that wood? Okay, it has to get it specially. This might be the correct one, boys and girls. It'd be awesome. don't know if there's a way of checking that. I mean, of doing that. Like, figuring that out. Maybe that's the color of the rest of his, self. I just brute forced it, though. I kept, you know, just going back and trying the next one, as you saw. So. Run, Kate Walker. Kate Walker, where are you going? Run. That gives me a little start every time. I believe this will be the correct one, sir.
Here are your feet, Oscar. I hope they fit.
Kate Walker, I see you managed to produce two XZ2005_B models.
Sweet. Oh, he does have arms. Oh, he was telling us about what model arms he need. He has arms. Hands, everything.
Allow me to express a real feeling of joy, Kate Walker.
Huggy time?
They really suit you. Comfy?
Very. You are very kind, Kate Walker. I am sorry to have to leave you.
Where are you going?
Can't leave.
I must find my train. Its departure is imminent.
Well, I gotta follow you then. Yeah, I can't do anything right now. Get back here. I gotta get to the train. Maybe we're gonna take a train ride now. All right, Kate Walker. Which way is the train station again? I don't even remember. No, it's not this way. That's like the way you turn the power on or something. Run, Kate Walker. Run into the bench. Get on the stack. Hurry. And then walk up very slowly. Hi.
Hey there, Oscar.
My functions do not permit me familiarity, Kate Walker. Even if you are my first and only passenger.
Me? Your passenger?
Yes, you, Kate Walker. Is it not for that reason you completed my production process?
If you say so.
Can we go somewhere on the train?
This train is amazing. I'm going to travel like a princess.
I am happy that you like it, Kate Walker. This train has been designed to optimize passenger comfort.
Let me just see if any new options come up, guys. I'm just
gonna... Oscar, you know you could just call me Kate. It would be so much nicer, especially as we're going on such a long journey together.
I am sorry, Kate Walker, but I have already logged your name. I cannot modify this data, and my functions do not permit me familiarity, Kate Walker.
Well, I hope your functions permit you to learn the difference between being familiar and quite simply nice.
I want to change my name to just Kate.
I have decided to come along for the ride, Oscar. Ready when you are.
Your ticket, please?
My ticket? What are you talking about?
The rules clearly state, Kate Walker, every passenger of this train must possess a ticket.
She seems nervous,
okay.
too.
Okay. And where do I get hold of a ticket?
Only the ticket vendor may issue tickets.
Excuse me.
You are in luck. The ticket office must be open now. You should go there immediately.
It is? Okay, let's get a ticket. He went to the ticket office. That's why the ticket office is open. Oscar, you crazy thing, you.
But it's you?
What can I do for you, madam?
But Oscar, it's me, Kate Walker.
Correct. Your name is indeed Kate Walker.
Oh my god.
Oscar, you know...
I am sorry, Kate.
Well, I hope your functions...
Alright.
Oscar, if you were in my shoes right now, what would you do?
My reasoning mechanism does not permit me to manage problems outside the mandate of my own functioning.
I can't wait to meet Hans Varlberg. What about you?
I would find the experience inordinately gratifying.
And I won't forget to congratulate him on the success of his incredible automaton.
Why, thank you, Kate Walker.
Momo?
Do you know Momo?
No, Kate Walker.
Are you the only automaton on the train, Oscar?
I have been designed to attend to all tasks relating to the smooth functioning of the train and the comfort of its passengers.
Okay, okay, Oscar. I don't doubt your talents for a second. Poor Madame Vorarlberg. I'm sure she would have loved to come along.
This train was designed for only one passenger, Kate Walker.
So, it's like I've taken her seat. This train is amazing.
I am happy that you like it, Kate Walker.
Alright, mission?
What can I do for you, Kate Walker?
A train ticket, please. Why, do you sell anything else?
No.
The only function of this ticket office is to issue tickets. You are requested to accelerate operations. The office closes in exactly 3 minutes. What can I do for you?
A ticket, please.
One ticket?
Yes.
One ticket. What is your final destination?
I don't know. It's you who told me I had to get a ticket.
A ticket to travel, then.
Wait, she had to buy a ticket. Where's the money? Train ticket for the mechanical railway departing from Valet de Land. This ticket is valid for one person and should be presented to any office of the mechanical railway when so required. Maitre Adfalter's practice. Valet de Land notary. Authorization for access to all or part of the movable and immovable estate constituting part of an inheritance. The Vorarlberg. I think how you say it, heritage. Description of the object: one mechanical propulsion locomotive, including coaches, accessories, and driver. The present document, stamped by the recognizing permitting authority, entitles the holder of this document access to the aforementioned property.
There you are. Do not lose it. This office is not entitled to produce duplicates. This advice also applies to the accompanying documentation.
What's that?
The authorization for the release of the train. The ticket officer may ask you for it at any time.
But I mean, you are the...
Attention! The exact moment has arrived to close this office.
Oh my god. Oh no, we got another call. Hope it's not Dan.
Kate, it's me again.
Oh, it's Dan.
Dan, I was gonna call you.
Sure you were.
Are you mad at me?
I've just called Martha and Lorma. They told me you weren't expected to return this week.
Oh, yeah.
So when are you coming home?
Don't know.
I don't know.
Don't care.
There's nothing I can do about it. The situation is kind of tricky, you know. At the beginning of next week, I hope.
Yeah, whenever.
Dan, please. Just hang in there, okay? The stakes are higher than I thought, and you know how much I love this job.
I suppose it's neither here nor anywhere to you that the Goldbergs are going to...
It is. I mean, it isn't. I mean, Dan, this really isn't the moment. You know I'm thinking about you. I love you, sweetheart, and I'll give you a call when I have some news. Promise. I've got to go now. I've got kind of a train to catch.
A train? Where are you off to now? This is crazy, Kate.
To tell you the truth, I've no idea. Love you, honey. You know that.
Kate!
Click. Okay. I'm gonna find your inner strength, Kate. To hell with you, and to hell with the Goldbergs. Thanks, guys, for watching. Tune back next time when we embark on a voyage in a train and say to hell with Dan. See you then, and bang bang boogie, and don't stop the boogie.